when we post on social media, we usually have some type of motivation. But if we just want to teach people and we want to make people feel good or entertain people or give them good advice and we have good intentions, then it's a good thing to post on social media. Like, we have a business and we make money doing it because we have passion doing it, then everything we post has meaning, has value. But if we're trying to post because we need attention and we're missing something in our lives, or we don't feel happy, or we need people to compliment us every day or to make us feel like that we're doing something good, that we're valuable and we have worth, then we're in trouble. Because if we post things, then we're relying on those likes or those comments. And most people are going to say nice things. They're never going to tell you the truth, because when people tell the truth, then they're viewed as hating, because people like will gang up on them and start fighting them because they are saying like, why are you saying those things and all that? Because people are usually really beta in the way they do things. Like, they're just really focused on following the crowd and not going to have a lot of people saying things. People are going to be viewed as judging or critical, or like, oh, you must be living a terrible life and you're putting other people down. But that's not always the case, that people want to share what they really think from their own opinion. Just like when people put things on Twitter and then somebody shares that on maybe an Instagram post, that's based on that person's personal opinion. That's not based on fact. So you can't be posting that stuff and then saying that this is fact because some random person said something, that they made a comment and that person thought that it was consistent with their personal views. Everything is personal views. Like you should not pass off things like this is truth. Like it's based on somebody's opinion, and then you're sharing it based on your views. So it's consistent with your views. It's not the truth. And it could be half the truth. If you have a mission to make people think a certain thing or to follow a certain, you know, path, then you're going to post things only that complement those things. You're not going to show the whole truth. You're going to say like, okay, this event happened in this time. And that's all you're going to say. That's a fact. But are you sharing why it happened or why somebody did something because of that event? That there's always a reason for why something happened. And people leave out that truth because they're trying to push people to listen to them, because they're trying to force something. So we have to be careful about those things, like the message that we're trying to send out, because there's usually a motivation and people know what they're doing. If somebody has a business and they're like a conservative, that they're trying to send that message about certain things, and it's consistent with them only sharing. So they're trying to base value on the truth, but then they're only sharing a certain side, but they're not being honest about their mission, about what they're doing, because they have a business and they know that they get all those people rowdy, you know, like, and excited, like the people that are within their base, then they're going to produce more traffic and more support, and they're going to make more money, and they're going to sell more merchandise, they're going to do more things with their business, because this is what they're following, like this message of like, I'm like in this certain base and I'm going to be doing these things. Whereas on the other side, people can make people think that everything is negative and dark out there, like in America, you know, United States. But you know what? Our opinion in the U.S. is not universal. Like, every country is different. And because people try to use the truth as a way to target others. Like, they think that people value the truth and like tell the truth, but then these same people don't tell the truth about why they do what they do, or they don't share like all details of their own life, but they try to throw around the truth like it's what matters most, but they never share everything. So the time spent on social media can be valuable, but it could actually go against you. It could actually hurt you. Because if you're spending too much time because you need to get attention or you need value, worth, and there's other things that you're dealing with in your past that you haven't resolved yet, then social media is going to be destructive in your life, because you're going to want to post things to feel, you know, valuable, or you're going to do things like, yeah, look, I'm protesting right now, or I'm following this message, and I'm doing good things. I'm doing human kindness, and I'm making a difference in this world. If you're showing that because you want people to see you, then you want to feel valuable. You want to feel self-worth. Then you're never going to heal from those moments that are still hurting you that you weren't able to heal. Like, we need like our open wounds from these past moments, these dark moments, to heal, so they become scars. Like, we're never going to forget them. They've happened to us, and they're a part of us. They're a part of our journey, and unfortunately, we can't like erase them and disregard them like that. They never happened. They did happen, but we can't sit there and just focus on them all day long and get angry and be negative and regret our lives and beat ourselves up and, you know, hate the people that did these things to us. Sometimes life is unfair, but it doesn't mean that we can't live a better life, like the way we imagine. Sometimes we get stuck in these like fantasies and thinking life has to be perfect, or that we wish all these things didn't happen so we could feel better. But you have to think about the things that you have right now, the people you have in your lives, the things that you've done that were fun, like trips, certain events and all that. Like, some of these things wouldn't happen if you want to go change your past and make it look like that everything is perfect, so people could see that you have this perfect life and you have these amazing moments, and then you don't really share everything that you do and say and think. Like, that's behind the scenes, that you don't show who you really are. Like, and sometimes that's okay, right? But if you're trying to portray yourself as being like, oh, I'm like, I have a great family and I have a dog and I have a kid and I have this new guy and I'm like so like awesome and perfect and I'm going to teach you how to live this type of life, then you're like really delusional. Because you're telling people like this is the perfect life, and you're creating a mirage of what the perfect life looks like, but then you're not sharing like how you were feeling when you were down on your luck and during your difficult times. You're not saying to anyone that these things happen and that you got stronger. You're hiding it. You're hiding the truth. Because people may think the same thing, or they may need to hear the truth about like how you felt and what were you saying to your kid, or what you were thinking in your mind. Because what you're thinking is who you really are during those times. Because you might fall into those times again. You might do certain things and revert back to being dark again when the sun goes down. Like, you might say the same things. You might act the same way. You might have like negative thoughts and be angry. Is this that when people are feeling depressed, like they enjoy the self-pity and they want people to feel sorry for them and to support them, but then sometimes they don't do the same for the people when they need it. Like, it's always about self. Like, they want to be selfish and do things, and it's almost like in their nature, like, I'm selfish, I need attention on me, need people to pay attention to me. But what about the people that support them? Like, are they helping them? Are they checking on them? Are they sending them messages for support or encouraging them to live their dreams? And is this that this life is difficult? There's a lot of ups and downs, and there could be exciting moments where you feel like you're lucky to be living, and then there's gonna be moments where you just feel like you're down and out and like you're just ready to go. Not like that you want to take your life, but you're just ready to go, like where you're just tired of this life. But that's natural, because people are going to feel that way. Just because people are famous and because they make money and people notice them and they're just super popular doesn't mean that they have the perfect life, because sometimes they don't have the privacy and they don't have, you know, the space or even the freedom to go anywhere, because people are fixated on their lives and they're judging them and they're critical of them. And that everyone has their own opinion because everybody wants to feel important. Everyone wants to be recognized as like, oh, I have my opinion matters. I'm valuable. Like, I contribute. I'm part of the, you know, the change or whatever message they want to send out there. So you see a lot of people that think that they have all the answers, but they don't know even how to deal with their own problems. And that's the problem. Like, if you have all these problems and you're trying to go out there and trying to fix everyone else's problems, but then you can't even like fix your own life. You may have all the answers. Maybe you do have all the answers and you know how to improve people's lives. But what about your life? It's not being selfish to go out and do some self-care and to focus on what you need to do and what you need to heal and how you could strengthen yourself and how you could improve on your weaknesses. It does matter what you do. Because if you don't do it, then nobody's going to do it for you. If you think a therapist could solve everything, or you think your fame or success or your traffic on your website or like your followers or like your subscribers, you think that could solve why you have this emptiness, it's not going to work. Because there's something much deeper and you have to come to terms with it and say like that I do matter. And I want the best life that I could live, because I only live this life once. And I don't want to be thinking about this stuff in the future, like when I'm at the end. I want to know that when I reflect back that there was happy moments. Like, you know when people are jumping around at a concert and is so excited and it was like a dream experience, that you want to feel like that's your life, like that it was amazing time, like the great moments that you shared with people and the moments that you went into nature and you shared with your pet, like all the moments that mattered and all the important things. That's what you want to think in the end. So if you think that social media is going to improve you because you need a million followers, it's not going to do that, because then you're going to be online all day saying thank you to like hundreds of people, and there's not a lot of people are going to give you, you know, that moment of like where you could have like a good conversation or something that's going to grow you or enrich you. Because a lot of people are just going to try to envy you or get jealous of you, of course, but then mostly they envy you, or and they're usually just complimenting you and praising you and all that. And that could get boring eventually, because you don't find people that are actually going to grow you and make you feel happy and like, oh, like that, I like that person because they bring a lot to the table and stuff. You're just gonna have a lot of people just telling you what you want to hear. I mean, be comfortable with hearing things that you don't want to hear, things that are honest and that things that you need to fix, and things that you know deep down inside that is wrong with you. And some people see it, some people are able to feel it, because you know they could be an empath or they could just have a lot of wisdom and they know, and they could help you. So you have to believe that life could get better and not look at the dark side. There is darkness though, but there's always light. So until the next time, value yourself, respect yourself, love yourself. Peace out.